Hey guys, I'm a verified educator at an academy, and along with that I'm also teaching live at an academy plus. To access my live classes you can take an academy plus subscription. Now an academy plus offers some interesting features apart from live classes, which include detailed and complete explanation of a particular course. Then there you have problem discussion for self-evaluation. You can also watch recorded version of the class in case if you miss out any live session. You have regular doubt clearing sessions for doubt clearing and to clarify all your problems. You also get access to the WhatsApp group to clear and discuss problem among the other plus students. Now if you have found these features interesting and want to join an academy plus, I'll recommend you to use my referral code, that is N_Huda, to get 10% discount on the subscription fee. Now that's all about an academy plus. Let's continue with our video.
Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. So this video is going to be about a question which was asked in June 2019 exam, and this was again asked for 4 marks, right? And why I'm taking this question, because this was based upon a very important and a very basic concept of Orgel diagram and to find out the number of transitions. Okay, so this is going to be some of the last videos which I am going to post before this December 2019 exam, because I just want you guys to revise this concept through these questions. Okay, so that is the only motive of taking this question. So I'll just try to explain the concept also, so that you just revise that as well. Okay, so along with this particular question, that concept will also get renewed in your mind. So let's start with it. So it says that consider the following statement regarding electronic spectra of high spin complexes. Now remember one of the thing, that high spin complexes is given to you. Now this Orgel diagram concept, or the concept of the Orgel diagram, is only applicable for the high spin complexes. So they have just made it very clear that okay, you have to solve this question for high spin complexes. That means you can apply Orgel diagram in this, right? So yeah, here two things you have to keep in mind. First, the number of transition. The second thing is the type of transition, that what kind of band actually you are going to get. So you have four options, like four statements. Statement one says that titanium plus in plus three oxidation state, its complexes exhibit one sharp band. Okay, then statement B says that cobalt in plus two oxidation state and chromium in plus three oxidation state complexes exhibit two broad bands. Okay, now statement number C says that manganese in plus two oxidation state complexes exhibit a series of weak and sharp bands. All right. And the statement number D says that nickel in plus two oxidation state, its complexes exhibit three broad bands. Okay, so they are focusing upon two things. First is the number of bands, or the number of transitions. The bands will arise with the number of transition actually, and what kind of transition it is. Is it a sharp transition or a broad transition? Okay, so let me just tell you one thing, that if you want to just find out number of bands, or the number of signals, okay, or the number of peaks, okay, if you want to find out that in the electronic spectra, then that can be done with the according to the number of transitions, okay, with the help of number of transitions. And you all know number of transitions you can find out with the help of Orgel diagram. Okay, so Orgel diagram is going to help you to find out the number of transition, and with that you can, the number of transition will be actually equal to the number of bands, or the number of signals, or the number of peaks. Okay, so in the electronic spectra of the complexes. Now the sharpness, okay, sharpness and broadness, okay, broadness of the peak depends upon few of the factors. I'll just let you know that when do you get a broad peak. Okay, now what is the when you are going to get broad peak and when you are going to get the sharp peak. So broad peaks are those, first of all, if you have two very close sharp peaks, then the particular peak becomes broad. Okay, so that's how we say that a particular peak is a broad peak. Okay, so the broadness of the peak comes if you have distortion in the geometry, or if you have distortion in energy level. Okay, energy levels. Generally, for the complexes, for the metal complexes, your broadness of the peaks arise with the John Taylor distortion. Okay, John Taylor distortion. So if you have John Taylor distortion in the complex, in that case your peak become a little broad. Okay, it will not remain sharp. Why is it so? See, let's say if I have a molecule which has something like this, which has like this is the d orbital, like this is t2g orbital and this is the eg orbital, and this is how the transition is happening in it. Okay, so in that case I'll get a quite sharp peak because of this. Okay, so this is how the shear peak I will get. But if jointer distortion will be there, then obviously t2g will split into two different energy levels and eg will also split into two different energy levels. So now the transition which I will get from the ground state will be this and this. So the energy difference between these two is quite less. So instead of getting a sharp peak, I will now get either two peaks with a particular shoulder, or it will look quite broad, right? So we get a broad peak. So either you get a broad peak or you get shoulder peak. Okay, shoulder peak. So these two things, broad peak and shoulder peak, you get because of jointer distortion. There are many other factors which affect the broadness and the sharpness of the peak, the difference between the energy levels and all. But for a complex, for the metal complexes, especially for the coordination compounds when you're talking about, so their broadness depends upon the jointer distortion. Okay, and also I have explained about like the difference in the peaks of your d orbital complexes and f orbital complex. So that is the other thing. But if you are just considering d orbital complexes, that is only about the coordination compounds, so for them the broadness or the sharpness of the peak or the shoulder peak arises because of the jointer distortion. So this is one of the thing which I wanted to explain. And the number of peaks you will obviously get from the Orgel diagram. So let's start and let's try to do for all these molecules, for all these complexes, let's see what kind of peaks you will get. So let's talk about statement 1, statement A, where it says that titanium in plus 3 complexes, titanium plus 3 oxidation state complexes exhibit one sharp band. So if you look upon the Orgel diagram, this is particularly like this is D1 in the electronic configuration, right? So the Orgel diagram, if you draw the Orgel diagram of it, so it will be like T2G will be in the lower energy state and EG will be the higher energy state. You just have to remember the Orgel diagram of all of these. And I have explained in my classes that how you make Orgel diagram, so that I think you guys are much aware about. So you are getting one band, right? So band, like the number of band is equals to one, right? But here this particular band will not be sharp band. Why? Because if you draw the electronic configuration of titanium in plus 3, so this is actually like you will fill it some in this way, that is your T2G will have one particular electron. Okay, so your T2G and this is your EG orbital, so T2G has asymmetrical electron filling. So over here you will have weak jointer distortion in the molecule, and due to this weak jointer distortion you will not exhibit a sharp band. Okay, although you will exhibit one band, but it won't be sharp, it will be a broad band. Okay, so you will get one broad band in option A. So that's why statement number A becomes your wrong statement. Okay, so half of the statement was correct, that you will get one band, but you are not going to get that sharp. Okay, so now let's talk about the second statement. Okay, so the second statement talks about cobalt in plus 2 oxidation state and chromium in plus 3 oxidation state complexes, and it is said that they exhibit two broad bands. Okay, so let's talk about cobalt first of all. So cobalt in plus 2 oxidation state, it's a D7 complex, right? And when you draw the Orgel diagram for a D7 complex, so basically you will get the lowest energy state will be your T1G, okay, and then you will get T2G, right, and then you will get A2G. So you will get A2G, and along with that you will get one more, that will be like T1GP. Okay, so you will get these transitions, like these energy levels. Now let's talk about the other one, that is the chromium. Okay, so in that case, if you draw chromium in plus 3 oxidation state, so this will be actually your D3 complex. And if I draw the Orgel diagram for it, so I will start from the lowest one is A2G, and in that case the next one will be your T2G, and then you will be having T1G, and the next one will be your T1GP. Okay, so you get there is a repulsion which you will see over here in the energy levels because of the non-crossover rule, obviously, right? You might have studied about this thing, right, that they do not cross each other because they are of the same symmetry. So now if you look upon the transition, so 1, 2 and 3 transitions, so there are 3 transitions which you will see in this particular case. And yeah, so there are three transitions. Which are those three transitions? So this is A2G to T2G. Then there is a transition between A2G to T1G. Okay, and then there is a transition from A2G to T1GP. So obviously, since the transition is not happening anywhere between the same symmetry energy level, so that's why all these three will be allowed, and there will be three bands over here. Okay, so this chromium exhibit three bands, not two bands. Okay, so you will get three bands in this particular case. So this statement was also half correct and half incorrect. So let's take the next one now. Alright, so talking about this statement number 3, which says that manganese in plus 2 oxidation state exhibit a series of weak and strong bands. Now, this is quite correct, because if you talk about manganese in plus 2 oxidation state, it is actually D5 complex. And when you draw a D5 complex, the electronic configuration of D5 complex in the T2G or in like in tetrahedral or in octahedral geometry anywhere, so you will have all the orbitals as half filled, okay. Now if you start doing the transition, some of them will be spin forbidden, okay, some of them will be spin forbidden, some of them will be like Laporte forbidden. So these spin forbidden and Laporte forbidden, if the transition is spin and Laporte both forbidden, that will be weak, okay, and if it is any of these allowed, that will be strong, right? So yeah, in this case we will have multiple transitions which can happen. Once this electron will go, then this electron will go, then the third one will go. So there are many transitions which are possible. Among these transitions, some of them will be weak and some of them will be strong, or some of them will be sharp, because some of them will be spin forbidden, some of them will be Laporte forbidden, and some of them will be either spin allowed or Laporte allowed, right? So that's why this statement is a correct statement. So third one was your correct statement. Let's take the last one now. The last statement says that nickel plus 2 complexes exhibit 3 bands. So that was quite correct, because nickel in plus 2 oxidation state is a D8 complex, right? And D8 has a similar Orgel diagram, just like your D3 was. So your A2G, then your T2G, then you have T1G, and then you have that T1GP, right? So T1GP. So the same way which we have seen in the last question, where it was D3 in the chromium case, so the same thing will happen here as well. Okay, so you are having three transitions here, from A2G to T2G, from A2G to T1G, and from A2G to T1GP. Okay, so like that, three transitions are possible. So statement number D was your correct statement. Now if you look upon the question once again at the end, just to summarize whatever we have discussed, how to answer that for that particular question. Let's take the question. Now if you just look upon the question, it says so these were the statements, right? So the first statement says that titanium plus 3 complex exhibit one sharp band. That was wrong. We have seen that it will give one band, but that was a broad band because of John Taylor distortion. Statement number B, where cobalt in plus 2 and chromium in plus 3, it was given that they will give two broad band. That was wrong. Chromium was giving us three bands because of the Orgel diagram, right? So this is wrong. Manganese complexes exhibit a series of very weak and sharp bands. So that is true, because it was D5 complex. And D5 complex have it will have spin allowed and it spin forbidden transitions. So spin allowed one will be sharp, spin forbidden one will be weak. Okay, so that's why it is correct. And the last one, nickel in plus 2 oxidation state, which was your D8 complex. And according to Orgel diagram, it was showing three bands. So that was also correct. So C and D are your correct answers. So option number C is the correct answer for this particular question. So this was a very good question from your from the Orgel diagram topic, and I have already made a video over it. So if you have not watched that video, you should watch that particular video. I'll attach that in this link over here. And if you are new to this channel, do subscribe to this channel. If you like this video, give it a like, and if you want to ask anything, you can ask that in the comment section below. So thank you so much for watching, guys. And I'll see you in the next video. Till then, have a great day. Bye-bye.